Hi, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with another GPU server from Tyan. This is the Tyan Transport HX TN83B8251. That'd be the general chassis. This one specifically is the B8251 T83E8HR-2T-N server, a GPU server. It supports dual AMD EPYC 7002 series processors with 8 drive bays in front, and you can install either 4 double-width GPUs or up to 8 single-width GPUs. It's also PCI 4.0 compatible. Let's take a look. First of all, I do have to point out that Tyan does a wonderful job with their packaging. There are little foam cutouts for the heat sinks, and the system comes with rack rails, which is a nice little cost savings. At 2U, this is a great general purpose system that also delivers powerful performance for AI and deep learning, thanks to AMD's EPYC 7002 series processors, which are capable of supporting up to 64 cores and 128 threads each. On this chassis, we are limited by the thermal design point, or TDP, of only up to 200 watts. But keep in mind, high-end EPYC processors will support up to 280 watts of power. Still, even limited to 200 watts, you can install a processor with up to 64 cores and 128 threads. You also get 128 PCI lanes, PCI 4.0, and still more cores than you could get with a comparable dual processor Intel-based system. Aside from the naming convention, which still lacks a certain simplicity, Tyan continues to knock out some very heavy-duty appliances. This one is actually a general purpose server that can be used to support a number of business critical and high performance computing workloads, depending on how it's configured. It's also a great scale out option for cloud applications. Aesthetically, the system is fairly generic. You don't get any fancy bezels to make it look all pretty, but what it may lack in looks, it makes up for under the hood with a number of high performance features. Is speed the new black? Down the center of the chassis are 8 3.5-inch storage bays, and above those bays are vents allowing more fresh air into the case to help reduce the heat given off by the dual EPYC CPUs and GPUs. A control panel on the right-hand side server ear offers telltale lights for LAN 1 and LAN 2, and a warning LED and an HDD LED. The color of the warning LED provides health information for a number of different systems. And then you have the on button and the reset button. That last button is for the ID LED. In the other server ear, you get 2 Type-A USB 3.1 ports for at chassis management. I don't think I mentioned, IT Creations is an authorized North American distributor of Tyan. Next question, are you interested in the Tyan Transport HX TN83B8251B8, that one, or perhaps another Tyan system? For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system listed on our site at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see pricing, and when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. It's that simple. The back of the system has 2 2200 watt redundant PSUs center bottom, which are flanked by 4 rows of PCI slots to either side. Above the PSUs are a few integrated ports, including a dedicated management port and 2 10 gigabit Ethernet ports. 2 more PCI slots on top are for an optional HBA bus adapter or HD RAID controller. That dedicated management port provides access to the integrated platform management interface, or IPMI, through the AST2500 IKVM for local and remote management of the system. It's also compatible with Redfish API. Inside the case, you can see a clearly defined cooling structure with 3 main airflow paths. The motherboard occupies the center of the system and is cooled by 3 high-performance fans. Fan sensors and temperature sensors on this motherboard provide information for more granular control over the cooling. 2 more air channels to either side of the motherboard are blocked off from the central airflow and have their fans set back a few inches to deliver cool air closer to those GPUs. GPUs do build up a lot of heat. Down the center are the 2 CPUs, which in this case are AMD EPYC 7302 processors with 16 cores and 32 threads each, operating at 3 gigahertz and 128 megabyte cache. Each processor supports 8 memory sockets for 16 active memory modules total in a 2 processor configuration. It will support up to 2 terabytes using 3DS registered DDR4 DIMMs, or up to 4 terabytes if you plan on using load reduced DIMMs. To either side are the left and right GPU brackets, which again can support either 4 full-width GPUs with 2 on each side, or up to 8 single-width cards with 4 on each side. There are a few double-width GPUs to choose from on Tyan's validated GPU list, which does get updated. Currently, you can choose from NVIDIA's Tesla A100, which is the new Ampere-based GPU from NVIDIA, offering 40 gigabytes of HBM2 memory with native support for ECC. There's also the Tesla V100S or V100 32GB, but still that A100 card is billed as being 20 times faster than the 32GB Volta-based V100. Or if you want a less expensive card, lower power consumption, and a single-width form factor, then NVIDIA's Tesla T4 GPU is, so far, the only tested and approved single-width card. It's also a great card for distributed environments. You can also pop an NVIDIA Quadro RTX 4000 in there, which offers superb ray tracing capabilities. For those other two slots on top, you can go with some superior network bandwidth to take full advantage of the processing power of this fully operational GPU server. Maybe with a Broadcom or Mellanox NIC supporting network connection speeds of up to 100 gigabit Ethernet, with one or two ports and a quad small form factor pluggable. Which brings us back to the storage, in that you can install a PCI card with dual M.2 drives that can be rated for either performance or redundancy. A discrete HD RAID controller will also provide control over your storage, plus support for SAS drives at 12 gigabits per second. The backplane on the system supports up to 8 SATA or NVMe drives. AMD's EPYC Series 7002 processors enable NVMe drives with a direct connection to the motherboard using appropriate cables and without all the switches and expanders. With the GPU and NVMe support, that's probably why you only have support for 8 NVMe storage devices, at least on the board. If you want to go with SAS drives, you will need a discrete controller, and there are a few to choose from. The storage drive bays up front also feature toolless installation and removal of 3.5-inch hard drives. There's 4 screws if you want to use 2.5-inch drives, so think about that. There's also a micro SD card slot on the system board for hypervisor support. For general purpose computing all the way to high performance computing for AI and deep learning development, the Tyon Transport HX something something something, kidding, the Tyon Transport HX TN83B8251, I'm not done yet, with specific chassis configuration of B8251-83E8HR-2T-N delivers. With support for second generation AMD EPYC series processors, plus NVIDIA's Ampere GPUs, you will get what you seek in a 2U server, and at a fairly reasonable price. I mean, it's still a server. Just a reminder, IT Creations is a North American distributor of Tyon servers and professional workstations. We also have all the parts and components on hand, I'm not sure if that's the same thing, to custom configure a system to your specifications and send it out for next day delivery, if need be. Like, subscribe, and comment, especially that last part. That's where it gets interesting. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.